Let's talk tech right now. FaceTune has been downloaded more than 2 million times. It's also the best-selling app on the iPhone app in more than 100 countries, believe it or not. FaceTune enables users to touch up their portrait pictures on their smartphones and tablets. Think getting rid of a few lines, a few wrinkles here and there. Our Middle East editor, Elliott Gotkine, is live in Tel Aviv and has more. Good morning, Elliott.
Good morning. No wrinkles here. Yes, I'm pleased to say I'm joined by Itai Tsiddon, who is one of the co-founders of Lightricks, which makes the FaceTune app. Great to have you with us, and wrinkle-free as well, I should add as well. Photoshop became a verb over the last, couple of decades. Is FaceTune going to be the kind of next? Are we going to be face-tuning ourselves and face-tuning that picture in the future? Is that how established you are now?
Well, I think it's already kind of happening, right? If you look at social media and the way that people use, the name FaceTune, it is being used as a verb occasionally. So, you know, hopefully we're on a good track.
Okay, wait, see what the Oxford English Dictionary eventually says on that. But what's driving this growth here? Is it just people putting up their portraits on social media? Is it people taking selfies? What's driving the growth?
So I think a lot of people's presence has gone online over the past few years. So people care about how they look online, first of all, for sure. But also FaceTune in particular is based on proprietary technology that just other products don't have. Four of my co-founders are computer science PhDs, which is, you know, who made this product. So it's a little different. I think that's kind of what's driving that user satisfaction.
And Adobe just leaving this market clear for you? They, of course, make Photoshop.
Adobe is more desktop-oriented at the moment. I think they're more focused on their move towards the subscription model than from the mobile. They're less of a mobile-first company. We really are mobile-first. That was our first product. Our technology is built that way. That's sort of where we are.
And the company's completely bootstrapped, which basically means it's financed by the founders. But you're in talks to raise more funds. What kind of numbers are we looking at here?
Well, there's a lot of interest from top-tier capital. I'm just coming back from the United States. I can say that and we don't take any of this for granted. You know, I think a lot of people are connecting with the vision of Lightricks, which is to do, you know, the high-end image processing and the platform shift to mobile. We want to be there. We want to be the player that does that. We think somebody's going to do it. There's definitely a lot of interest in it.
And what kind of valuation will we be looking at?
Well, it's on the upper end of the scale, I think, for a company that's about a year and a half old.
And in terms of what happens next, I mean, we've got FaceTune in terms of fiddling around with your portraits, making these pictures look better. Mm-hmm. What comes next?
FaceTune is just the beginning. We have a full product pipeline, which will accelerate more or less according to various strategical considerations. But there is a long product pipeline where we will be bringing cutting edge technology for image processing to mobile. Nobody seems to be doing much of that, and we want to do that. So you'll be seeing more from us that brings stuff that you haven't seen before enabled on mobile by Lightricks.
Okay, and worth pointing out as well that your app's going to be on Android in the coming weeks, and you are, for a startup, quite rare, profitable as well. So, Itai Tsiddon, thanks for joining us this morning. Guy, Olivia, what would you change on the FaceTune app out of your pictures?
quite a few things. I'm not sure we have time for that, but I do think I will be downloading FaceTune. Thanks so much, Elliott. We appreciate it.
Yeah, we're not going to dwell on that one too long.